Ralph in Michigan, welcome to the show, sir. What say you?
Hey, Josh.
Hi, Josh.
Hey, Ralph.
And Kathy said hi, too. Hey, listen. you know, for some reason, you know, you just spark things in me. Well, they're always sparking, but, you know, I figure I got to say something, too. I got two comments. Okay?
Well, wait, before you get to your two comments, I have to tell you the reason why we spark something in you is because the slogan of this show is to motivate, inspire, lead, and defend, and inspire means to spark. So, okay, continue.
Well, I got two comments, and one of them would be, you know, on the health insurance issue and the doctors and that, would be that, stop and think about this. How many times have you heard people say, oh, we got to limit lawsuits?
Right.
But they're never on the receiving end of a bad doctor where you get your leg cut off or your kid dies or your wife or spouse dies or whatever. You know, and they don't understand, you know, what all is involved there. They just look at it as, oh, no, that's the reason why our health insurance is going up. No. It's a bad doctor the reason your health insurance is going up.
Well, it's definitely one of the reasons.
Well, if insurance companies would take and evaluate what they're insuring, you know, it's just like, you know, it used to be if you were a bad driver, insurance companies wouldn't touch you.
Right.
You know, well, if they're bad doctors, guess what? The insurance company shouldn't touch them, and then they'd have less lawsuits, less cost in insurance. Am I correct? I mean, there is some kind of sensibility there, is there not?
There is some sensibility there, yes.
Oh, and let's not forget personal responsibility. You and I and everybody else has seen it, too, where you got kids that are doing things that, you know, when I was a kid, if you did something like that, and not only would you get hurt doing it, but then when you got home, your dad would take a belt and wrap the crap right out of you. You remember that? You know, oh, yeah, I was riding a skateboard.
Yeah.
I broke my teeth out. You know what your dad would do to you or what he'd do to me? And what do you hear nowadays? Oh, well, we got health insurance, so a kid can go out and take his life in his own hand, no big deal. I think those are unneeded, don't you?
Or worse yet, they'll sue the skateboard manufacturer for making a dangerous product.
Well, there you see my point. Anyways.
Well, thank you, Ralph. Thank you so much for calling.
Wait a minute.
Oh, go ahead. Okay.
I do still have hope for people, though, because we went out on base out at Selfridge last week. My mom had to get her ID card renewed. Anyways, we went out there, and like always, it's hurry up and wait out on base, as you probably know. But I went in there, and I just got done listening to the Josh Telly show.
Amen, brother.
And I had to run my big mouth. But I ran it in truth. Well, needless to say, these poor people have been out there for hours waiting in line, and I show up, and I start running my mouth about truth that's going on. And within 5 minutes, what do you say, Kath? Was it five minutes? Within 5 minutes, they had, three sergeants come out, and the main sergeant saying that I need to get out of there. They're going to take me next in front of everybody else to make sure I get out of there. And, I mean, she's pointing the finger right at me and this
You're
and that.
Not even on the list.
And I'm not even on the list. But it was surprising what it took to get these people motivated to stand up for their rights. And they did. They all rallied around and stood up for their rights and got the situation squared away. And when they were trying to keep me quiet, the people stood up and said, no, we want to hear more.
And it all started with your morning two-hour segment of the Josh Tully Show. Ralph, I love it when you call. Thank you so much. And, yeah, you know, Ralph brings up a really interesting point here, and that's the lawsuits that are involved. People are going to say, well, Josh, you know, what about the lawsuits? Should we cap the lawsuits? The reason there's discussion of capping lawsuits is because they know the system that they've created so far is already broken. They need to cap it now because they're in a broken system. If we went back to a regular system, a regular free market-based medical industry, we would have the ability to regulate that ourselves. Now, as we've had pointed out on this show, there are hundreds of thousands of deaths that are because of the medical system. I'm not saying all nurses and doctors are bad. That's not it at all. But I'm saying is the system is broke, and when there's no penalty for having a broken system, there's no reward in trying to fix it. See, if we were in that free market-based medical system, and yes, it works. If you don't think it works, call me. I'll straighten you out. If you don't think it works, You're messed up. But if we look at that, and let's say you had Hospital A, which is now a business and competing with Hospital B, and Hospital A continues to have death after death after death, word is going to get out and everybody's going to go to Hospital B. Now, Hospital B is going to obviously make sure that they have the best healthcare possible, that they have the least deaths possible. And when we get to a place where we're no longer rewarding the medical practice for the illness and rather rewarding them for the cure or the healing, then we switch the dynamic again. Because, folks, let me tell you another sad thing about this medical situation and one of the reasons why it has to go back to a free market position or it's never going to work. And that reason is right now we reward the disease. There are people who have cured cancer. We have had a documentary filmmaker on this show even as last week talking about how there is a cure for cancer now. Cureforcancernow.tv. It's a free movie. Go watch it. We've had Dr. Brzezinski on this show. And all these guys with these great remedies, with these great healings, they're not allowed to offer them to you because it fixes you. And the government says, no, you cannot fix the people. Well, wait a second. Let's backtrack again and make this make sense to me, please. You want the government who says you can't heal people to be in charge of your healing? That's the solution? That's the idea you came up with? I am sorry if you're on the left and that's your opinion, but you don't have to be a right-winger to realize that's stupid. You just have to be a thinking human being to realize that's stupid. I get it, left-wingers. You have hearts, so you want the government to benevolently provide all of your healthcare needs. But we know that they reward bad behavior. They reward the disease, not the cure. They cover up in order to provide. That doesn't make sense. If you really cared about people's health, you would be part of the Josh Tully healthcare plan. And as sad as it might sound, in the past 9.5 minutes or whatever it happened to be, I laid out a better healthcare plan than all of your politicians have in the past 80 years. And that's not to say that I'm great. It's saying this, to say that they're pathetic. Because if they can't figure this out, you know that they're in bed with the people who are trying to make this thing continue. That's your only two options. They're either stupid or they're complicit. There's not another option where they're good meaning and they're working their way towards the solution. No, 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 no. How did we get on healthcare anyway? There was all this other stuff that I wanted to cover. Man, I need a longer show. But it comes down to this. We need to get the healthcare back in control of the people. And what's so funny is the government and the left-wing side or the government healthcare supporting side of this argument is using this as an excuse. Well, we need to have government control of healthcare. So the conversation goes back to being between you and your doctor. You're an idiot if you believe that's what that actually meant. In order for it to go between you and your doctor, we'd have to take the government out of it. Why do we not see the obvious logic? Because if we drew it out, how many people are in this conversation? The government, the doctor, and the person. And yet you're saying, oh, no, by having the government involved, it's a conversation between you and your doctor. Morons. There's three people in that equation. Why don't you see three people? Do you see dead people? I mean, really, what's wrong with your thought process that stuff like this makes sense to you? If you want it to be between you and your doctor, then we need to get everybody else out of the room. We have to get the insurance company out of the room, the underwriter out of the room, the adjuster out of the room, the medical lobbyist out of the room. We need to get the 75 other people who are involved in your health care, which would only increase if the government got involved, because now that's another mouth in the room. We need to get them out of it. Make it between you and your doctor. All right. Man, it goes so fast. Back right after this. Last segment coming.
The GCN Radio Network, providing the world with hard-hitting talk radio. GCN. Great talk radio starts here.